So, paraplegia, non-traumatic paraplegia. So, in this non-traumatic paraplegia, what is paraplegia? Paraplegia is nothing but paralysis of the legs. So, it is mainly caused by disorders of the spinal cord and cauda equina. So, why paraplegia occurs? So, paraplegia occurs because of the disorder of the spinal cord and cauda equina. So they are classified as traumatic and non-traumatic. So traumatic paraplegia, road traffic accidents and falls. Non-traumatic paraplegia, so this has got multiple causes. So if there is trauma, it will cause paraplegia. This non-traumatic paraplegia, so this has got the multiple causes. So in Africa, paraplegia is among the most common community-based neurological disorders in Africa. So paraplegia, so this can arise from a lesion either within or outside the spinal cord or cauda equina. So how can this paraplegia occur? So this occurs because of it can arise from a lesion. So where will be the lesion? Either within or outside the spinal cord or cauda equina. So these are classified as compressive and non-compressive. So under non-traumatic paraplegia, we have this compressive paraplegia and then we have this non-compressive paraplegia. So compression, so this compression is caused either by bone or other masses. So how is the compression? So this is caused by bone or other masses. So what are the main compressive causes? The main compressive causes are Pott's disease, TB of spine and tumors, usually metastasis. So what are the compressive causes of paraplegia? So the compression is caused either by bone or other masses. The main compressive causes are Pott's disease, that is TB of spine and tumors, so usually metastasis. The main non-compressive causes are transverse myelitis secondary to viral infections, HIV, TB and very occasionally syphilis. So what are the main non-compressive causes? So the main non-compressive causes are transverse myelitis secondary to viral infections. So these viral infections, they cause transverse myelitis, HIV, tuberculosis and occasionally syphilis. The less common causes include Devic's disease, B12 deficiency and helminthic infections. So what are the less common causes? So the less common causes include Devic's disease, B12 deficiency and helminthic infections. And there also exists in Africa a large group of nutrition related non-compressive paraplegia. So these are called as tropical myeloneuropathies. Nutrition related non-compressive paraplegias. So what are these nutrition related non-compressive paraplegias? So these are tropical myeloneuropathies. So these include conjo, latharism and tropical ataxic neuropathy. The nutrition related non-compressive paraplegias are tropical myeloneuropathy. So under this we have this conjo, latharism and tropical ataxic neuropathy. So now we have the main causes of paraplegia. So under main causes of non-traumatic paraplegia, we have this compressive causes and non-compressive causes. So under compressive causes, we have this extradural. So these extradural include Pott's disease, metastatic carcinoma or myeloma, cervical spondylosis, epidural abscess and echinococcus cyst. So what are the extradural, okay, extradural compressive causes? Subdural, under subdural we have this extramedullary and then we have this intramedullary. So under compressive we have this extradural, subdural. So under subdural we have extramedullary and intramedullary. So extradural means Bott's disease, metastatic carcinoma or myeloma, cervical spondylosis, epidural abscess and echinococcus cyst. Under subdural, extramedullary, neurofibroma and meningioma. Subdural, extramedullary, we have this neurofibroma and meningioma. Under intramedullary, we have this astrocytoma, ependymoma, tuberculoma, cystosoma ovi and syringomyelia. So under intramedullary subdural, we have this astrocytoma, ependymoma, tuberculoma, cystosoma and syringomyelia. So non-compressive. Under non-compressive, we have transverse myelopathy due to viral infections, HIV, tuberculosis, syphilis, HTLV-1 and Devic's disease. Some infections which are causing this transverse myelopathy. Viral infections, HIV, tuberculosis, syphilis, HTLV-1 and Devic's disease. So under nutritional, we have this Gonzo, Lathyrism and tropical ataxic neuropathy. So under nutritional non-compressive disorders, we have this Gonzo, Lathyrism, tropical ataxic neuropathy. So in vascular, we have the sickle cell disease and dural AV fistula and hereditary familial spastic paraplegia and B12 deficiency. Vascular, sickle cell disease, dural AV fistula, hereditary familial spastic paraplegia and deficiency of vitamin B12. So under common causes, Bott's disease, transverse myelitis, malignancy, infection and nutritional.